Hi everyone! Today I'm going to be breaking down the Paris Climate Agreement, what it means for our world, what it means for youth, and what it means for you. Climate change is without a doubt one of the most existential threats facing the world. As young people, we're the ones that'll be experiencing the most intense effects of climate change. So many issues, from natural disasters, to poverty, to income inequality, to refugee crises, and more, will be greatly worsened by the climate crisis. For example, we're expected to reach a 1.5 degrees Celsius increase in temperatures and above, which is also the point when coral reefs are projected to decline by 70 to 90%. At a warming of 2 degrees Celsius, virtually all coral reefs will be lost. It's not only a tragedy for wildlife. Around 500 million people rely on fish from coral reefs as their main source of protein. Like many challenges, this one is tough to tackle. Here are three reasons why. 1. Climate change is one issue that absolutely can't be tackled alone. Nature doesn't know any political borders, and the actions of each country and person will affect everyone. So to solve the climate crisis, countries have to work together. 2. That's not easy. Countries are contributing to vastly different extents, depending in part on their level of industrialization. While China contributes 28% of the world's total carbon emissions, for example, countries like Turkey, Mexico, and Australia contribute just 1%, with many coming in much, much lower. So, who's responsible for doing what? It gets even more complicated when we remember that the impacts of climate change are just as varied, with smaller countries much less able to weather extreme variations in weather, flooding, crop production, and more. And 3. Climate change is a very long-term issue, which can make it hard for people and politicians to want to invest resources into solving it. These are exactly the challenges that global institutions like the United Nations are trying to tackle, and why it's so important for us to work together on shared global challenges. Now let's look at Paris, but first, a quick history of global climate agreements. The first, the UNFCCC, was at the Rio Earth Summit in 1992. The next was Kyoto in 1997, which was notable because it was the first time countries committed to carbon reductions. But no, not all countries did, including the US. Paris was the next and most recent, negotiated in 2016. The Paris Agreement has a few notable parts. First, its main goal is to limit global temperature warming to below a 2 degrees Celsius increase above pre-industrial levels, with an ideal goal of 1.5 degrees Celsius. In order to do that, countries agreed to individualized sets of goals to try to limit greenhouse gas emissions. Each country set climate commitments called NDCs, Naturally Determined Contributions. These contributions are updated every 5 years, adjusting them to be more and more ambitious as time goes on. Secondly, the agreement also provides a pathway for more industrialized nations to help less industrialized nations adapt to the brutal effects of climate change that they will disproportionately encounter. It also has a bottom-up structure, with each country being able to determine and commit to their own unique goals and build consensus with other countries. President Obama signed the Paris Agreement, but President Trump withdrew the United States in 2017. It didn't actually go into effect until 2020. While Trump claimed that the agreement was unfavorable for the U.S., many U.S. states and cities still committed to the climate goals set under the Paris Agreement. On the first day of Joe Biden's term in office, he signed an executive order rejoining the agreement. Now, why is this all important for young people? Well, we're the ones who have to survive the future terrifying effects of climate change. As the average global temperature increases, as the seas rise, as the weather gets more intense, as our natural resources get depleted, as species of animals die out, we will be the ones that have to find a way to live. If we want a safe world for ourselves and future generations, we need to hold our politicians and leaders accountable and make sure that they act now. Many millions of young people around the world have taken on this challenge, leading climate protests, lobbying, and innovation. You may have heard of some of the most famous ones, like Swedish activist Greta Thunberg and Ugandan activist Vanessa Nakate. Young people from all walks of life are uniting around the issue of climate change and demanding accountability. The Paris Climate Agreement is a great step forward, but we're just getting started.